What is going on, guys? Unite the Clans here, back in your life. For the first time in, a couple of days since a Minecraft video. Actually, maybe yesterday. That's fine. I actually wanted to record some Ark Survival today, but I couldn't get onto the server. So instead, we're going to do some Minecraft. I built this tree, or the beginnings of this tree, in the last episode. And this is going to be the site of a church for Hollow Grove. Hollow Grove is the settlement, the sort of underground hobbit village I built out in that direction. And we built a pathway that comes all the way through this hill, dug entirely out of it, and leads out to this one, which I have then hollowed out and built a giant tree on top. And we're going to build some sort of spiritual or religious altar in the roots of this tree, where the people of Hollow Grove will have their, whatever, their prayer. And so this is with the inside. It's being hollowed out, and I'm going to take this all down a couple of levels, and then right here where all the roots come through, we're going to build something grand. But before we do, I think we got to get this tree done, and we got to really have an idea of what it's going to look like, and it'll inspire the entire interior of this place. I'm thinking like a giant Christmas tree, more or less, and I'm wondering if it has to be a whole lot bigger. We'll see. I've got a bunch of leaves in my inventory, and there are a bunch more over here. Mostly spruce, but I do have some birch. I'm going to try mixing those in just for a little variety and see how it looks. The funny thing is I'm kind of tempted to start at the top and get an idea of how big it'll be, and then I can keep kind of expanding it. But if I start too wide down here, I don't really know how it's going to look. I have an idea in mind, guys, but I think this one's going to be frustrating enough because it's up high that I'm going to do a lot of it away from camera. And today's actually might be even a little bit of a shorter episode because I'm recording it on sort of shorter notice. I'm doing my Easter Sunday with my family today. We're not really a religious family, but we love to get together on those big holidays, and we'll actually be cooking a big meal, and I'll help be hosting people at my place. So if this video is shorter, I apologize. But to those of you who watch this series, you're my favorite people out there. You guys are like family to me, and I hope you enjoy your Easter Sunday. And we get to keep doing this, and maybe a few new people get tuned into this series, and this little community will grow. Either way, enjoy your day today, guys. Happy Sunday, and I will do my best to get a little episode with a well-built tree for you at the end of it. That is starting to look like something, guys. I'm intrigued. It's hard to tell at this early stage, but I wanted to bring you back for a bit of this, and I think what I'm going to do is pillar up with some gravel that's, you know, I climbed as high as I could climb on the outside of this and then pillared up with a little gravel. And I think I'm going to keep doing the same thing. This clearly needs to start getting a lot bigger. So I'll see if I can maybe beef up a couple of these last layers. And ideally, we're going to get down to this part here of the tree, or maybe this part here with leaves. And I'm going to fill in a lot of these gaps with leaves. And I might end up making these bits smaller unless the foliage really comes far out. But I'm going to keep messing around, see how it looks, and I'll come back to you guys after another segment of building here. Okay? All right, guys, I have done a lot more. As you can see, the top of the tree. I don't know how well we can see it. I must put my gravel away. That's okay. I didn't plan on climbing up and building right now. But that's how it's starting to look, and I thought I really need to get an idea of how wide it's going to get. What are we going to be looking at? So I did this, and I think that's a decent enough guide. Like, I think if I just, keep doing this and work my way around, and maybe something like that, I'm going to be able to actually get a pretty good outline of this, and we'll be able to mess around and see how it's going to look once we've got, some real layers and depth to this. So I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to keep on working this out. I am slowly putting torches up and down the tree and then filling all this interior space, any space up here with leaves. But I think I'm going to keep working on this ring, keep running around the outside of it, and hopefully I will be able to finish this build in this recording. I know I'm in a bit of a hurry today. I have work tonight, and have that big Sunday dinner tomorrow. So if I'm getting you guys a Sunday video, I need to be doing some work right now, and I need to keep it up. So let me go grind away, because I get work done quicker when I'm not on the camera or on the microphone. Sorry, and I will be back with you guys in a minute. As usual, nearly starving to death. I have got this ring wrapped all the way around. I'm starting to run really low on the old oak leaves. So I'm going to see how much of this I can get done just with spruce. And then if I have to come in at a later point and really come through and add in some little... Oh yeah, we're running out quick. That's all right. I got a box full still. I'm keeping my box stocked. We need to, I'm probably going to need more, I'm almost definitely going to need more leaves to get to the end of this build, but we're getting there. And it's starting to, like, take shape. It's starting to feel a bit, yeah, this is the way I did it. Feel a bit like a tree. There you go. Cool. I know there's going to be a lot of cuts. I know there's going to be a lot of little breaks in this episode, but I can keep you guys with me for a minute or two while we get this bottom layer laid in. It's starting to feel like a tree. I was one of those tree climbing kids as a kid. Like, I'd climb really high, loved getting up there. It was really, I don't know, something really fun. And it really all has to do with the trees that were around me when I was growing up. They were all maple trees, like sugar maple trees. But those are great for, oh, goddamn, I really need to bring my pruners. Yeah, the sugar maple trees are great for climbing. They just have this smooth bark, and my house growing up was completely surrounded by them. It was awesome. I hope that all kids, whether you guys are the kids or you're the parents, the kids get an opportunity to do that kind of stuff. It's the kind of stuff that makes parents cringe a little bit because it's just not crazy safe, but it is so much fun and so empowering for a kid to be able to look at a tree and go, I'm going to climb that, and then do it. It's pretty fun. I'm glad I had that sort of experience. And I think, you know, I can understand, like, the way that we're building this here, we're building, like, a holy tree, a sacred tree, a religious tree that these Hollow Grove dwellers, that they sort of worship. And I guess this one's going to be going... Yeah, all right, we're getting there. And so anyway, I was saying, we're going to make them sort of forest worshipers in tune with nature and have their prayer circle be in the center of an ancient old tree and its roots. It's going to be pretty cool. But I can get that. I can get sort of, if you're going to have a god, have it be nature. Have it be, you know, the amazing beauty of nature. Because if you're a sort of an a-religious person, you're not really particular about what you find, you know, if you don't follow some very specific creed, there is a lot of beauty in nature, and I can totally get why Stone Age people really worship that. Those were the first gods, were the animals and the trees and all that sort of stuff. And I think it's cool. We still kind of think of Mother Nature today as that sort of a powerful force. I don't think too many people believe she's real or a real thing, but it's definitely a big part of being human, I think, and like early humans all seem to have this reverence for the world around them because it provided them with their food and their shelter. And I think that's some of the ideas that we're trying to incorporate into this build. Yes, it's a giant tree, and building a giant tree in Minecraft is cool. And my favorite YouTuber is a great tree builder, custom tree builder, BDubs. I always talk about him in this series, as this series is largely inspired by his building series, BdoubleO. If I didn't mention it, but where was I? Oh yeah, I'm loving that we're getting to get into this kind of detail with the builds. We're really getting to think about what these places represent and the people that are living here. And now that we've got like this, you know, these people, we've given them now a whole religion. Meaning some of you guys who watch the live streams, I live stream Minecraft at least once a week, either Wednesday night or Monday night, and we just kind of worked out some neat ideas last time I live streamed, came up with some cool stuff, and that kind of inspired this big tree and this big build. I have a lot to do on this, guys, and like I said, I work a lot faster when I am not on the microphone because I can just focus on what I'm doing. This is some busy work, so it's keeping me... I've been able to talk, but a time is coming up very shortly where I have some really detailed, make the big plans, make sure this tree comes out looking the way you want to look it moments coming up. So why don't I let you guys go? I'll do yet another cut in this video, and we'll come back once I'm pretty much done. We'll have a look at this thing, okay? Welcome back, guys. This is going to be the weirdest little episode. Let's blast this fool. Weirdest little episode with all the cuts and the big time difference. I think this is the only one in this new season of Minecraft where I've started recording and then had to finish recording the next day. But that's the case today. I ran out of time, had to go to work last night, guys, and now I'm waking up. I had to wake up Sunday morning and get immediately to work on, you know what I need is some gravel. I think I left that down here. Let's just take a little bit of fall damage. Yeah, yeah. Yes, I had to wake up early this morning and start cooking Sunday dinner, which is now on the way. Everything's just ready to go, waiting for people to arrive, pretty much. So I am back to this, and hopefully I can get this damn video out to you guys today. I don't really have any gravel. I don't know what I did with the damn stuff. Let's put dirt on the bar, and let's put these oak leaves back on the bar. Now that that creep has been dealt with, the old creeper. All right, so we, this episode, have been building a giant tree. We started it last episode, and as you can see, I am coming along. I just need to get my butt back up there. Yeah, it looks pretty good. I like it. And didn't I put dirt? No, I didn't. It's fine. We'll do it now. Yeah, this is been a fun one so far, guys. I'm liking how this is going. I basically started doing rings around the outside. I've gone through in a lot of the layers and added in some of the birch leaves, and I now have a giant stack of oak leaves as well. I've been growing some trees, which is good, and been working quite a bit this morning after dinner was finished and just left cooking, working quite a little bit to get this tree looking the way we want to look it. So yeah, you can see I've done rings around the outside almost entirely in spruce, which is that one, and then I just fill in the interior gap, and then we'll come through, maybe smash a few out or clip a few out if I have my shears on the in my inventory, and then just add in a little bit of flavor of I don't know how the oak leaves are gonna look. I think they'll be too bright. I might just stick to the birch. But I wanted to see, nonetheless, how they're going to look. And the easiest way for me to do that, I'm not too worried about waste, is just, yeah, finish going around the outside. And then before I do the next layer, we'll just go bang that out, put some there, bang that out, put some there. And this just adds a little bit of variety and a little bit of depth. I try and do this no matter what I'm building, is not just use one texture. But really get creative, add in a few. I mean, if you were making a tree, you could really go nuts and throw in green wool or green clay, depending on what it is that you're trying to build, or the look that you're trying to cultivate, I guess, right? We have a few minutes to finish this one up, and then I really need to wrap this episode up, and I don't want to do any more cuts. So let's not mess around too much more with these birch leaves. Actually, you want to add in one oak leaf? We'll see how it looks. I think it's going to be way too bright green. That's not oak, is it? Is that how it looks? Oh, maybe that is how it looks, because we're in a winter biome. That's actually going to be solid. It doesn't look at all like it looks in my hand. I forgot, if you grow these trees here, that you get this texture. Okay, well, I haven't done this anywhere else in the tree, so we'll have to go in and add a few little clumps of oak leaves. I like the way that looks. Cool. All right, well, let's keep up working with spruce here. Where is my guide? Where's the thing that tells me how big to make this layer? Here. I think, yes, it's a decent, I'm in this layer. This is one of the narrower layers. And I think I need to really make, because this top part of the tree is narrow and the bottom part of the tree is big. So this is a really important part in making it sync up. To just to see how it looks. And that's one of the times when building, like just merging how wide it is up there to how narrow it is here. We need to do the right sort of width in these last two rings to get it looking the way we want to get it looking. And that's where building in survival is kind of a pain, because I'll have to use dirt to get like to get out far enough away from the tree to see what it looks like. I'll have to make a little dirt bridge, but we're almost there. And this, the leaves of the tree, I really wanted to get finished so that we can have an idea of how this tree will look, and that's really going to inform the design of the sort of religious building that's going to be underneath us. And I've chosen to make none of the spruce wood, the branches show through, or the trunk, whatever you're going to call it, just so that we get a really green-looking tree. And then the roots will look all the more kind of stark and naked when you haven't seen the wood from the tree throughout the build. All right, this is coming together. I had a bit of a fun couple days, guys, working late last night. It's Easter weekend, so it was just a bit of an odd day working where I work. And then interestingly, earlier this week, I went and played Laser Quest. At least that's the brand name of what it's called in a lot of parts of Canada. That's the big company that does laser tag, basically where they put you in some sort of black light maze with spray paint on the walls. They give you laser guns and laser vests, and you just go blasting people. And I went and did this with my brother and my sister, who is home for Easter from Ottawa, where I used to live. I now live closer to Toronto in Canada. For those of you that have been watching this channel or this series for a long time, maybe back when I originally did this series, we have just the right amount of leaves. This is going to be perfect. Okay, I need to flesh this out a little bit so that it transitions and maybe do one there. Oh, this is coming together. Don't run out of spruce leaves, please. And I guess I'm going to beef this up a little bit. Maybe, whoops, I didn't mean to do that one. Maybe come out like that. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Whoops. Stop doing that, fool. Okay. Let's... I'm getting there, guys. Yeah, played laser tag. And the first game was incredibly fun. I did quite dominantly. Not dominant. I think I was 9th out of 35. There were a lot of kids there, too. So just me getting to a good spot early. You know, when you're in one of those places, you kind of want to be where the high ground is when people are mostly in the low ground, because then they're not seeing you. And then if most people get to the high ground, and this is like a two-story sort of dark maze that you're in with these laser guns and these stupid vests, then when everybody's up high, you want to be low because you can see people really well in the dark from a distance. And, I mean, the guns don't work crazy well over a big distance. Oh, we're freaking almost done here. I'm running out of blocks to have to place. All right, this should come out a little bit. It needs to. And then I think we need to bring this part out a little bit too. Oh, that might be enough just right there. So let's back up and take a look at this thing. I'll go find my dirt pillar, and we'll walk down, and we'll take a long look at this. Guys, I'm thinking this thing might be done. We're going to have to take our look, but I'm excited. And this is the first giant tree I've really built. I built some custom kind of like oak trees, but they're sort of for the side of a path. Like if you have a road, you know, it's only like 8-9 blocks tall. That looks pretty cool. I'm wondering, I might have to make the middle section a little bit bigger so that the bottom and the top blend. But for now, I kind of like this. It's actually really hard to get a good look at it from down here. Whatever, nightfall is coming, and this is going to be just about the end of a 20-minute episode. I think in order to get this episode out quickly to you guys today, I might skimp on the music or the end cards or who knows what. There might not be cards at all, or the description might be really short. Who knows? I'd love to get a video out to you guys and just have it done so that if you all need a little company on your Easter Sunday, you can have it. But I will be gone. I will be out with the fam enjoying sort of a brunch. I think we're getting together mid-afternoon for me. And you know what? It's sunset. So let's take this break. Let's call this video, guys, episode 24 of Building with UTC. I am Unite the Clans, and today we built this gigantic tree. It is the beginning of a holy tree. I think it maybe needs to be taller and wider even. It's big and it's the biggest tree in the area, but it's not dominant enough. I'm going to keep working on this and I'll maybe continue to build it up. It might actually need more light. It might need more torches closer to the outside, but either way, it's looking good for today, and I thank you. For those of you that missed the beginning of it, we built the trunk and the roots in the last episode, episode 23. And in the next episode, I think what we're going to do is really start working on the interior here. And we'll start working with these roots and building this hollowed out hill into a holy place of prayer. It's going to be fun. And I thank you guys for watching. I, as always, am Unite the Clans, and I will see all y'all in the next episode.